You have seen a great presentation just before me. You know, that's beautiful images of 4DCT of Boris and many cases. Means we will skip all the liver cases that you have seen. And this is the installation we have in Strasbourg. The concept here is to talk about more about oncology and 4DCT today. We will focus on the oncology part. And telling you that the idea of combining a CT and fluoroscopy is nothing new. If you think about this, in 1980s, the first publication was done with the drainage of an abscess done with a mobile C-arm and CT scan already. I mean, this is an old story. In 1991, this is in Strasbourg. That's our first combination of CT and fluoroscopy. The only problem was the distance between the table and the gantry. And after this date, we were using this combination forever. Means that was very convenient for many cases. Then we had the second generation here with the steel C-arm and the CT scan, allowing us to go a lot more, doing more difficult cases and more advanced cases. And as you see, we were moving the fluoroscopy manually in both sides. When you do this combination, there are some advantages. You have the extremely nice quality of CT scan, as you can see. Here we can be happy with the old quality of CT scans here, but the quality of fluoroscopy is a mobile fluoroscopy. Radiation is high, the quality is not the best, and when you want to do combined NGO procedure, you don't have the contrast you need. Communication with CT and fluoroscopy not existing, and switching from CT from fluoro was easy. Then we had Robert-François Dondanger, who has done the first combination of a real NGO system and a real CT scan. It was a very good idea, but they needed to tilt every time the table in another direction, bringing the patient to NGO and come back to CT. It means they had the good quality of fluoroscopy, the excellent quality of CT scan. However, the change between fluoroscopy and CT was very cumbersome and difficult. That was the problematic. Then we had the first convim CT, which has we thought first, now we have the CT and fluoroscopy in the same machine, which was the idea to making the quite nice quality resolution imaging with CT and having the great NGO. The first thinking was we can do a lot of procedure we are doing in CT scan in this room, and as you have seen a few publications telling even ablation procedures can be done in convim CT, and that's been done. As you can see here is one of the our case. At the moment it becomes complicated and complex, at the end, you really don't know what you are doing. And doing every time a CT needs 30 seconds coming back, and when you do more than 3-4 convim CT, it becomes really, really painful. Because you need to wait, you want to see, and when you have complications, it's difficult. It means when convim CT, the quality of scan you obtain and the field is very reduced. You don't have the same quality, but you have the excellent fluoroscopy in the room. But today, we have another option. It's the 4DCT. And I show you the movie Julien has done. It's a little bit too loud. Can we just please? I think everybody will wake up and will not sleep tonight. That's a real how it works. You have both, you know, you are switching from one to the other extremely easily. That's it. Means you have both systems at the same time. Julien, that was for you. As you can see, you have the NGO in one side, you have the CT on the other side. As you have seen, the advantages Boris really underlined, you have the old combination of excellent quality fluoroscopy, you have the new combination of everything you need with reduced dose, and at the same time, you have a fully equipped interventional CT scan. This is essential for what we do. And you are switching from one to the other. And most complicated procedure can be done very easily. And majority of the case we do, we need the fluoroscopy, we need the CT scan, we are switching from one to the other. At the moment you need more than 4 CT scans during your procedure, better to be in such a room and not in the convim CT, because then it becomes very painful. combination of both. Sometimes you are telling me it could be complicated, but you get it very fast. This effect will disappear after 1 or 2 weeks. You know exactly what you are doing, and you are combining the procedure. And the good thing is, when you do the CT scan, the machine is memorizing exactly the position of the procedure and where you want to have and which angulation you want to have the fluoroscopy. The patient is automatically coming down. The table adjusts, and the fluoroscopy go automatically in the right position you need to. It means this is very fluent now, and it's going very fast. Anytime you need the fusion of images, anytime you need to put the precisely the electrode, like here, inside the body, you need to do a cooling and injection in the same time, that's the best combination you need to have. And as you have seen, everything is green here. I mean, you cannot be more spoiled than this. Having the quality of CT scan, having the quality of fluoroscopy, and the two machines communicating together. They know where they are both. That was the difficulty we had at the beginning, that the CT and fluoroscopy were not communicating at all together. Today, we don't have this problem. What can we do in oncology with this system? When you think about this, today, we need to push it a lot more. Boris showed you all the advantages of the system. You have seen the interventional radiologist is in the room. All liver case you have seen, this is no discussion. For all the combined procedure for the liver, this is no discussion. This is the gold standard to have something like this. Boris showed you beautiful cases. When you have this, it's difficult to come back to something easier. That's the point. When you get spoiled with this, you don't want to come back and work in a beam CT alone. I think you agree, Boris. Huh? Now people are not fighting anymore to go to the combined room. Look at this. Using this 4D effect is you are doing acquisition, you see exactly, you see this, how the cooling of the cone is done during the ablation. You can be safe, you are doing the cryo, and you see exactly the cord is protected in real time. And at the end, you can cement everything easily and do your procedure. When you have three rooms like us, we have the MR room, we have the convene room, and we have the CT, 4D CT. You have three different rooms. When you want to do such a procedure, you are just occupying one room, because you can do everything together. You see here we have a patient with recurrence outside the vertebral body, and that's a patient they're asking us for a focal control. This case should be done, and you know in paravertebral ablation, should be very careful not doing any accidental obstruction of the medullary arteries. That's why you need an angio just before. That's what we do. We do the angio, okay. Safe, you can do the ablation. There is no Adamkiewicz artery in the field. You can do your ablation. Such a procedure before, we have programmed it in 2 times. Once the NGO, a few days after the ablation. Today you can do it. And as I said, for such a case, you just change and we make one room busy and all the other tombs are still open for other procedures. And the anesthesiologist can work in the other rooms too. But when you don't have it, you have just a CT and a cone beam, which was our case before, that you have 2 rooms busy at the same time, and you are not getting used to it. When you do a procedure which usually doesn't need a lot of fluoroscopy, like this case, it was an ablation, a microwave ablation of the liver mets, immediately after, we had a bleeding. Large bleeding. What you do usually from this case is you move the patient out, you bring them to the angio room to do the embolization, because that was a quite notable bleeding. But here, during the same sedation, you are safe. You say, okay, they have a complication, no problem. We do the embolization on the same session. The patient wake up, you tell them, I had a bleeding, but it fixed. At the same time, in the same room. This is a lot more, okay, you don't need to have complications, but then when you have it, it's safe. That's a huge team behind this. It's not a one-man stand. You need radiologists, you need radiologist technician, you need the nurses, you need all this administration to make this work, the engineers and everybody. That's a teamwork, and a machine like this can do a lot for all your team. And if you see the department, as I said before, with all our setting, with the 4 room installed for oncology, a reception, the patient arrive at the reception, then you have to think about this. They don't care about what you have in the room. You know, the patient is not telling, I'm coming to see you because you have a 4D CT room. This is not the way. They come to you because you're able to treat them fully. That means when they come, they are immediately addressed to go and to see the interventional radiologist in an office. You need to see every single patient yourself. You are explaining to them you are existing. You are not a technician. You are not just good because you have the 4D CT room or you have the MR. You are good because you are a clinician. You can judge, no, I cannot do something for you, you need to go to radiotherapist, or I can do this, or you need to go to see the liver surgeon. That's our point. Means, you know, having the room is okay. You know, a long time ago, we were a little bit, you know, prehistorical. It was just doing some biopsy, thing like this, but today, you know, we have progressed. Now we are, we have the X-Men technique, we can do a lot more than before. Sure, but the technique is not everything, as I said before. As you can see, we can do everything in such a room. You know, for oncology, you can go from the simple biopsy. Boris showed you all the complicated cases of taste, ablation and embolization at the same time, balloon positioning, all the bone procedure can be done, and a lot of palliative cases are done in such a room. And you can see, Boris told you already, for all this ablation with hypervascular tumors or near the vessels, the embolization immediately done before our balloon positioning is essential for a good oncological effect. Means we are thinking much more oncological, and we learn to think like oncologists and like surgeon. Security margin, full complete ablation, and follow-up of the patients. Those are done. It's not just done in the liver. When you have a hypervascular meds, they tell you take care of it. Hypervascular means you will have the cold sink or the cool sink effect. You are in the room. You are very comfortable, you do the embolization during the same sedation, the patient is not blocked many days in the hospital, you do everything the same day, embolization, ablation, in the same session. That's an essential point. We know there is now, we are bringing more and more proof that doing the rationale of ablation and other procedures, here we have ablation and consolidation. You know that every time you ablate bone, you are producing the Italian specialty of ossobuco. It will break. It will break. This is systematic. It's delicious because it's becoming soft. Means every time you do an ablation, think about, do I need consolidation or not? This is essential to know. That's a case Julien has done a few days ago. That's a very fresh case. As you see, they are asking us to take a focal control of this meds, but because it's a clavicle and fractured, you need to consolidate this. Means you need precise positioning of the cryoprobes, CT scan, and you need your fluoroscopy to be able to do your pin fixation and cementoplasty of this patient. Sure, it will not give him a tennis shoulder anymore, but he can use his shoulder again and be able to cut his meat alone. Oncology, as you have seen, you know, we don't have so much of competition anymore. Means people were thinking, do you have any conflict with the others? No. You see, today when you have a recurrence like this here, and oncologists are asking you, if you have done radiotherapy already, surgery is impossible, can you take and do a focal control? With all new methods we have, with the instrumentation we have, yes, we can. As you have seen, we can protect the cord, we can freeze the tumor, and then as you can see, the PET CT control can show you, not systematically, but in many cases, a nice focal control. Means we are pushing more and more the borders to make it more and more aggressive. Means no concurrence, we are just complementary. We don't have any fight. More weapons, better for such an aggressive enemy like the cancer. Means we need to be together, and those combinations are usual. You see here, we have another case of an aggressive hemangioma. These patients need decompression because it's a compressive hemangioma. You need surgery, but you know surgery of hemangioma means bleeding. In this case, we need consolidations, sclerotherapy, and surgery. What we do in the same session, we do the phlebogram here, you see, sclerotherapy of the patient done, then the patient is transferred to neurosurgery. Look at the quality of fluoroscopy they have, the poor guys, compared to what you have. That was what we had before. Huh? And then they do the decompression, no blood loss. As you can see, they love this. Neurosurgeons are always impressed when they open a hemangioma, is no bleeding inside anymore. But this patient needed to be transferred from one room to the other one. Why can we not do both together? And that's the idea. In a room like this, installed in the environment of sterility we have, we can do both together. Here is a renal tumors. We want to do a focal treatment, but a surgical treatment. We need a partial nephrectomy. You know, for a partial nephrectomy, what they do, the procedure is done like this. First, they go to find the vessels of the kidney to make the isolation of the vessels so they can close the vessels during the ablation so they don't have bleeding. First time, you go to the kidney hilum to find the vessels, then you go to the kidney, you see the tumor. At the moment you see the tumor, you have 20 minutes. They close the vessels. During 20 minutes, they do the resection. This is quite a complicated procedure, but they are used to it. What we propose to them is why we are not going selectively, hyperselectively, find the vessel which is feeding the tumor, put a balloon inside, you do your cellio, you do your video surgery. At the moment you are finding the tumor, we close just these vessels, means we are not putting the whole kidney in ischemic 20 minutes, but just the tumor. And that's what we have tried to do, and you can see in the 4D CT room, the NGO is done, we find the vessels, that's Emanuele Boata who has done this, we find the vessels, and then you do immediately a quick CT scan showing you, right, we have the right superselective vessel which is going to kidney, then we turn the patient in right position for the surgeon in the same room, they do their video surgery in the room, they get to the tumor, and look at this, no bleeding at all. No bleeding at all. These procedures are opening. When you are having a 4D CT, if you open it to the surgeon, they will be happy to come to work with you. You do a part, they do a part, they are just happy to work with you. This is a new opening for us. When we have done this case, we have never dreamed to push it further. And a few weeks ago, we have the first patient coming for the recurrence of a glioblastoma. After having the authorization of ethical committee neurosurgeon, we said this patient has no chance to have a complete ablation. Why not proposing to this patient to have a open the same procedure and a cryoablation of the brain? I'm not talking anymore. I'll let you see the movie Julien has done. Can we have a little more sound, please? Because of the environment they can't work in. Has to be moved to the MR now because the ice is just visible with the MR. Go back to the 4D CT room because you need to remove the part of the brain which was treated because the edema will be huge if not. Then they close it and we go back to the MR room. It's like a half day, yeah? I know, but we are a university, that's where we need to push further all the procedure. When you need a room like this, you just need to know that something like this is not easy, and the work in the room is something very special. It means when you think about a room like this, you need beginning program it very nicely. I think everybody remembered this part. Is a lot of work. Means you have to plan it from the beginning on to make it work. This is how it is, but when you have it, you are really happy to have this one, and we are lucky to get a second 4D CT room next year. Just to thank Julien again for the making of all these movies, because I don't know how many cameras were in the room, 7 or 8, and he even done something very special at the end. He has done it with his drone to tell you how important it is to have a large bore. It's important to have a large bore to be able to fly through it to make the movies he has done. Thank you, Julien.